What's Mirzy doing in there?
I don't know. Yeah, I like it, though. I don't hate it.
Yeah. Why the angry face?
Well, it's more of a serious face.
Serious.
An angry serious. Face. Okay. It's Lawton Order, and we've got some business to attend to. Josh Morrissey set to have a hearing for this interference play on TJ Oshie. We're going to show it to you right now. Your thoughts, gentlemen?
You know what? A lot of people are saying this is like the Mike Matheson hit on Elias Pettersson. I don't see it exactly that way, and I'll tell you why. It's not a play where guys are going back at each other for something that happened earlier in the game. It's not a play where Pettersson lets up or Oshie lets up. It's just a continuation of a play for me. So I wouldn't be surprised if, like, watch this play right here with Matheson. That's a little extra see you later. I'm upset at something that happened. Matheson's not a dirty player either. It's just emotional right there. If you go back to the Morrissey one, I just don't think that it's the same intent. I'm not saying that he won't get suspended, because I think that he will, particularly because he's been suspended before, if you remember back with Eric Staal.
Yep.
But I don't think it'll be two games. I think most likely it'll be one. And we can take a look quickly at Eric Staal right here and what happened in this one.
Yeah, and that wasn't good. No penalty on the play.
Right.
Now how you missed that one.
Yeah, and that's one that obviously should have been a penalty, but the game happens fast.
That's
and
true.
The refs
that's
don't have
point.
Every angle on the ice covered. That's one where you're really relying on the ref maybe to see it out of the corner of his eye. And you see here again last night, Morrissey's got a beat there, and I don't know. Do you
he
see
does,
the
well,
same thing?
Well, I would say this. I didn't think it was quite as demonstrative as the play with Pettersson and Morris and, and Matheson, but I thought he was finishing pretty hard there, and it seemed like he could have stopped that hit, but it was an intense moment. It was late in the game. They're holding on to a one-goal lead. I do think he's, because his history and the fact they're having a hearing, I do think he's going to end up getting suspended. It was similar.
Yeah.
It wasn't quite the same.
It could be a fine, but it's more likely.
And Oshie was pretty dinged up on that play.
Yeah, absolutely.
I mean, he
was dinged up.
He stayed in. I mean, that was a situation where they had the goalie out. They were trying to score. He wobbled to his feet, and then he kind of staggered back into the play because he knew it was too long to get to the bench in that circumstance. But, you worry about T.J. Oshie. He gets hurt
a
lot. He's in the battle. He's in the battle all the time, and I'm just hoping that he's okay. But I suspect that Josh Morrissey will probably get a game or two for that. And, the fact that he's done this before, at least he's had a suspension before, and we don't know if Oshie is hurt.
Right.
Those are mitigating factors that could maybe make this more. Who knows?
That example really highlights how difficult the job George Parros and the Department of Player Safety has, because I could take that as a guy coming off the wall and almost springboard off and he finishes him, or you could take that as he slams him when he doesn't
exactly.
have to.
You're right.
And
you're
he
right.
could have started.
Tough.
And that is so hard to ask somebody to mitigate, but that's the job they have. They accepted it, and I wish them good luck with it. Whatever their decision, it's going to be wrong.
Yeah.
Because that's the way it always
Someone
is
will think
guys.
It is.
Somebody
yes.
will think it is.
Yes.
Right. Exactly.
Well, the other, very interesting thing about this game in particular was the start of it. Braden Holtby, a late scratch, ends up
that's
not starting.
Holtby.
No, Holtby was nowhere to be found on
that's
the ice of the Washington Capitals. That is Gavin McHale, the University of Manitoba women's hockey goaltending coach, who was called in as an emergency backup to Phoenix Copley because Holtby was not available.
Oh, boy. You
Pretty
said
cool.
you saw this guy play
I
years
actually
ago.
Saw him play in junior in Seattle. He played in the Western Hockey League for a couple teams, but I remember distinctly I was representing Nate Thomas Thompson in my old days, another guy, Zach.
And you
it's
can
Gerald.
See him there.
That's, he
had a suit up for the Avs last February, so he's been in this spot before. This is him coaching. Pretty cool.
With the women's team, yep.
This is one of the really unique things about hockey. What other sport has this that you could think of?
Yeah.
Where you have a backup player.
I can't imagine it.
Exactly.
And we remember in Chicago last year when he was forced into the game.
The accountant was forced
into the game. Yeah,
Scott Foster.
So
exactly.
You never know, but I thought it was funny when he was leaving that tape there. He was going off the ice, and one of the Cap fans like leaned over and gave him like the high five. Like, I wonder if he even knew who he was. Just
maybe not.
Maybe it's Holt. Sarah, hey, high five.
Yeah.
Just for a little protocol there. Every team has somebody.
That's right.
Well, and he's the Winnipeg Jets guy. He's
exactly.
their emergency guy.
Yeah. But they rotate. It's not the same guy. Most teams will have two or three or four guys. They may cover 10 games or whatever. Mm-hmm. They got a schedule. They got to be there. They got to have their equipment. I don't know if they have a pregame meal or not.
Yeah.
But they're told specifically no alcohol.
Well, that's a good idea.
Yes.
Good thinking.
Yeah, that's a good thing.
I need to recruit Gavin to just stand beside me while I make my picks, because clearly he's lucky, because he's done it now a couple of
times.
Right. If they're on rotation, then he's drawn the lucky straw.
And he's very
more
tall,
than once.
Apparently.
6'7".
Six seven. That was my scouting report. I remember he was
Monster.
Very tall. He was the backup goalie for Seattle.
Ridiculous.